Christ is risen. Christ is risen. And we're here to baptize Austin. Christ is baptism. It's a wonderful time to do it. As we said earlier, the Resurrection Sunday has been traditionally the most holy day in the Christian calendar. Today, the most baptisms were performed. A lot of people would wait until this day to get baptized. Especially, you know, in the probably 3rd century, 4th century, something like that. Let's open up in a prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this beautiful day. We thank you for the resurrection of Christ. Thank you so much for what he suffered on our behalf and has overcome death, and that he has looked forward to his return, for he will raise the dead. He will conquer death and raise our bodies to life. Father, we just wait for that eternal life, the kingdom that you will bring. And Father, we know that we can enter that kingdom when he comes, unless we enter it now first, the spiritual rebirth. And that's why we're here, Father. We want to baptize Austin. Father, I pray that you would be with us in the baptism. Be with Austin. Pray that his sins would be washed away from east to west, Father. And pray that you would imbue him with your Holy Spirit. As Jesus said, we must be born again of water and spirit, that we can have the kingdom of God. Father, we just pray that you would be with us in this service and in this baptism, and that your Spirit would be hovering over the rock. We sing a song.
Son and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to observe
I have commanded you. Lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. And this is what we've been spending the last few weeks doing, and we will continue to do, which is teaching and instructing to observe all things that Jesus taught us and commanded. All of the Sermon on the Mount and some of the Gospels. So he sent them out to make disciples and to baptize. This is also echoed in Mark chapter 16. Same, it's a parallel account of the Great Commission, using slightly different words, where Jesus said to his disciples, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He who believes and is baptized will be saved, but the one who does not believe will be condemned. And so what happened? As the apostles remembered what Jesus said here, and he sent them out in the book of Acts, the very first thing they do, they go into the upper room to wait for the promised Holy Spirit. Acts chapter 2, the Holy Spirit is poured out. People ask, what in the world is happening here? And they're all speaking in other tongues. Peter explains it, and he tells them that they crucified the Lord of glory, and that they should, they say, you know, in this case, what should we do? How do we respond to this gospel message that you preached to us, that Jesus is the Christ, that he's been crucified for our sins and been raised from the dead, and that we're guilty of doing this? What should we do? And it says that when they heard this, they were cut to the heart. And Peter said to the rest of the apostles, and they said to Peter and the rest of the apostles, men and brethren, what should we do? Peter said to them, repent and let every one of you be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins, and you shall receive the Holy Spirit. This promise is to you and your children after you, and whoever are afar off. He mentions that many were added to the church that day who have been saved through baptism. In this receiving the Holy Spirit, we just sang the song Sanctuary, that one of the reasons that we're to remain pure and holy is because the Holy Spirit will indwell us, and we become a temple of the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit, God, will dwell in us, and we should keep ourselves pure, as the Scripture says. So Peter did exactly what Jesus said when these people asked, what should we do? Message to them was the proper response to repent, to be baptized for the remission of your sins. We see this in Acts chapter 3. We'll also look at Romans 6. This goes nicely with Resurrection Sunday because baptism is identification with Jesus' death, burial, and resurrection. And as he came up out of the grave alive, that he come up out of the watery grave alive inside. As he says, Paul says, what should we say then? Should we continue to sin so that grace might abound? Certainly not. How shall we who died to sin live in it any longer? Or do you not know that as many of us as were baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into death? Therefore, we were buried with him through baptism into death, that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, even so we should walk in newness of life. For if we have been united together in the likeness of his death, which we're doing right now, being baptized and being united in the likeness of his death, then it says, certainly we shall also be in the likeness of his resurrection, knowing this, that our old man was crucified with him, that the body of sin might be done away with, that we should no longer be slaves of sin. Very important passage. Also, Colossians 2 is similar. Peter also says in his epistle that baptism now saves us. And John 3 says that, you know, Jesus said that we must be born again of water and spirit into the kingdom of God. So, this is a great opportunity. I know that Austin is going to be wonderful in his walk with Christ. I pray that he's blessed in everything that he does. And so, we'll go ahead and start. We'll face the west, which I was doing. Face the west, and we're going to ask you to renounce the the devil, his pump, and his angels. Amen. All right, now facing the east. Facing the east. This is the east, is the direction that Jesus Christ said he would return from the east. Christians would face the east and go through the interrogation of answering these questions, affirming the faith, the Nicene Creed. All right, turning the east, it says, all right, Alston, do you believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen? Do you believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the Son of God, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father, and that through him all things were made? Do you believe that for us and for our salvation that he came down from heaven and was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary and became truly human? And for our sakes, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and on the third day rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. You believe that he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father, and that he will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and that his kingdom will have no end. You believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, and who has spoken through the prophets. Do you believe in one holy, universal, and apostolic church? Do you acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins? And do you look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come? Amen. And what is your good confession? All right. Because of your great confession, and in the presence of God and the angels and these witnesses, I can now baptize you for the remission of all of your sins and be added to the church and the kingdom of God. All right. Yeah, I got done up.
Others gifts of wisdom, other gifts of boldness, The bathrooms were just cleaned.